Hey, remember that 51 minutes of time off that I told you I had yesterday for work? Well, let's just say it's about to jump down by about 37 minutes. It's 7 o'clock and I just left the house. I start work at 7 o'clock, and according to Google Maps, it's gonna take 37 minutes to get there. It could be a little shorter than that, it could take a little longer than that, but right now it says 37. So that means I don't really have the option to be late on upcoming days. I mean, maybe like once, but that's about it, and only by like 10 minutes. Long story short, after I went to bed last night, I could not fall asleep. I had my fan on full blast, and I was sleeping on top of my blankets, but I was still sweating like crazy. So I ended up just laying there, and I think I eventually fell asleep around like 4, maybe? So when I woke up, I basically just said, screw this. I am getting more sleep, even if it's only like 30 minutes. So that's what I did, and that's why we're here now. But I'll let you know tonight or whenever, if I remember to, just what time I ended up clocking in. According to my car, it's 90 degrees right now. My face looks kind of shiny. I am very sweaty. I cannot wait to get home as long as the AC is on, which it probably won't be, let's be real. This is the entrance ramp to the highway on the way home, and it is completely clogged up. I don't understand why, but I feel like I'm gonna be, it's gonna take a while for me to get home. Well, the cops have funneled us off of the highway, so I can't even go the way that I normally go home. Luckily, I know an alternate route. It's the route that I take whenever I take Steph home after work, so I'm just gonna do that. But now the problem is everybody's going that way, and there's still people actually entering the highway on the other side, so they're gonna have a fun time when they get up there and realize they're not even able to continue. Apparently, there's been a crash just past the bridge over there, which sucks, and that's what's causing all this traffic, but it is affecting, like, this entire area. Honestly, today's been garbage at work, and this is just the best way to end it. I was thinking about streaming tonight, but now it looks like I'm not gonna be home in time to do that. So I made it home. It's now 7:35, which is honestly fine. I'm gonna start my stream around 8, just before 8 o'clock. Probably not gonna get any vlogs edited tonight, but that's not a big deal, because I have some scheduled for tomorrow already. So tomorrow when I get home from work, I'll just edit 6 and hopefully get them all done. I guess we'll see. If I have time after stream, then I may edit like 1 or 2 tonight, but we'll see. Anyways, I wanted to talk about this real quick. Dan Avedan and the Super Guitar Bros. I ordered this months ago, it feels like. Of course, signed by Danny. And yeah, this is just an acoustic album he put out with the Super Guitar Bros. It's a cover album. I've yet to actually listen to it. I purposefully didn't listen to the digital version of it because I wanted to listen to the physical version first, if that makes sense. Shut up, channel. But yeah, I have this now. I also wanted to mention that Pokemon Snap 2 has been announced. New Pokemon Snap has been announced, and that makes me want to play the original, which I may just Let's Play. I may just Let's Play that game now. There was like a Pokemon presentation this morning, and apparently they're doing one next Wednesday as well, which I'm pretty excited about. They talked about the Isle of Armor DLC, they talked about some weird cafe game, and also Pokemon Smile, which is a toothbrushing game. I'll leave a link to the presentation below and on a card so you can check it out for yourself. And they also showed off some Pokemon Go stuff, like Galarian Farfetch'd is now available, I caught myself one. And I think Mega Evolution is also coming to Go, which is pretty exciting. So I'm pretty excited for the future of Pokemon. And then of course we've got the announcement next week. People are speculating either Let's Go Johto games or Diamond and Pearl remakes, but everybody's always expecting Diamond and Pearl remakes. So anywho, I'm gonna set up for my stream. The Isle of Armor DLC is currently downloading on my Switch, which is way over the other end of the house, closer to the router, because it's taking forever. Let's talk about the Isle of Armor DLC for Pokemon Sword and Shield. I just streamed it for 2 hours. It was actually more like 2.5 hours because I had to wait 30 minutes for it to actually download at the start of the stream, but the VOD that I'm uploading is about 2 hours long.
Well, first off, I want to say that that stream was fantastic. Zach raided me with like 18 viewers. We got a couple more subscriptions, Bryce and Chris, I believe. And then right at the end, Nova was like, hey, here's 10 gift subs. So 12 new subscriptions in that stream, which is incredible. Also got a couple follows too, 7 follows or something like that, I believe. And it was just, it was a really good stream and my heart is so full and I was literally at a loss for words at the end with Nova doing that. So I can't thank you enough, Nova. I'll link Nova down below so you can check him out. Anyway, so the Isle of Armor, it seems fun. I'm not super far into it. I've got myself a Kubfu, which is the Pokemon that they kind of advertise the DLC with. But then I kind of stopped the stream right after getting him, but so far I'm really enjoying it. It's like, the way I can best describe it is, it's an entire map that is a wild area. And the wild area was just kind of one section of the original game, and it was pretty underwhelming, honestly. Like, it's cool for 5 minutes, but then it becomes pretty underwhelming. The one in the Isle of Armor seems to be better. It's got more dynamic terrain, it's got caves and stuff you can go into, it's got water that you can, different like water pathways and stuff you can go on. There's a giant ocean with a giant Wailord in it. Honestly, it's so much fun so far, and I'm gonna stream again. I'm gonna say Saturday night, that's what I'm gonna aim for, because I can go a little later on Saturday night because I don't work Sundays. That is the plan, but even just for a 2-hour stream, like that, it was pretty incredible. And I do actually recommend you get the Isle of Armor DLC. I don't recommend you do what I did, which is buy it for both games, which is, that came out to $60, but I'm insane, so. Anyway, that is where we're gonna go ahead and end today's vlog. It has been a fun day. I mean, work was pretty boring, but I did have that Pokemon news to hold me over throughout the whole day. You know, Pokemon Snap, or new Pokemon Snap. That's exciting. I'm gonna look into ways that I can record the original Pokemon Snap. I think it was on the Wii U eShop, but if I remember correctly, N64 games kind of don't look that great on the Wii U eShop, so I might look into emulating it so that I can actually do a Let's Play on it. That is definitely a game that I want to Let's Play now. I might do a live stream playthrough of it first just to get the gist of it, but then I'm thinking I'll Let's Play it. Yeah, it's 11:41. I'm just uploading some more AOT2 that I exported last night. It doesn't need to go up yet, it's going up in a couple of days, but I wanted to get everything uploaded. I have tomorrow's videos scheduled, you know, 6 vlogs and the AOT2 video. And then tomorrow when I get home, it's gonna be a vlog editing night. I'm hoping I can get 6 done. So it might be another late night tomorrow, but that's honestly not that big of a deal because I'm gonna get to bed right after filming this clip tonight, so hopefully I get enough sleep. I did only sleep like 1.5 hours last night, but yeah, hopefully I get more tonight. So that is gonna do it. The link to that live stream VOD will be up on a card, or probably already was up on a card, and ow! Check out Nova, give him some love over on Twitch and on his Twitter. Thank you all for watching, stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then.